I mean, this is quite an unprecedented allegation against the Saudis. The Saudis, of course, denying that claim, and they are, of course, a big business client for Europe. How is Europe negotiating these tricky waters?
Well, very carefully. I mean, the EU quarter, as you can see, is just waking up to this new news. So there has been no official reaction as of yet. The European Diplomatic Service, the EAS, will be watching the case and treading, of course, very, very carefully. If this case is, of course, confirmed, there'll be pressure, though, on all the EU institutions to come out strong against Saudi Arabia, because press freedom is, of course, one of the fundamental values of the European Union organisation. Now, for the moment, we have already seen Harlem Désir react. Now, he's the media freedom information representative from the OSCE, that's the Organisation for Security and Cooperation in Europe, and he said this is an unprecedented crime against a journalist if, of course, confirmed, and those who are responsible must be held accountable. And NGOs have gone a step further. They said they don't trust neither the Saudis nor the Turks to investigate this incident, and they're calling for an international transparent investigation with international, of course, investigators. They're calling on the institutions to call Saudi Arabia out for this and to criticise their human rights abuses, and of course saying that this would be a very bad, sad day for anyone who's in favour of human rights and who's ever criticised the regime of Saudi Arabia.